in fact, the winner of the first ever Dave Jackson Teaching Award, so I think it should be an interesting talk. So be sure to come next week. And with that note, let me turn to this week's speaker. It's a great pleasure to welcome Dr. William Happer, who's professor in the physics department right now at Princeton University. He got his bachelor's degree from the University of North Carolina, went from there to get his PhD in physics at Princeton, went from there to being a professor at Columbia University, where he also served as co-director and then director of the Columbia Radiation Laboratory. And I think it must have been during that time that you were out, that he came and spent a sabbatical leave here working with Erwin Hahn, working with, I think, Dick Maris, some other people in hyperfine structure. And then in 1980, he joined the faculty of Princeton. In 91, he was appointed Director of Energy Research in the Department of Energy by the first President Bush. He stayed at DOE until 93, helping the Clinton administration during the transition period, then went from there back to Princeton, where he was named Eugene Higgins Professor of Physics, Chair of the University Research Board, and he's been there pretty much, I guess, ever since. He serves as chairman of the steering committee of JASEN. This is a group of scientists and engineers who advise the federal agency, federal government, on defense, intelligence, energy policy, other technical problems. One of their products, JASEN is a quite distinguished organization of extremely distinguished scientists, produced a book called The Long-Term Impact of Increasing Atmospheric Carbon Dioxide Levels, sort of related to today's talk, but interestingly, this is from 1982, I think. So this is he has long-standing credentials in this field of the effects of carbon dioxide on our atmosphere. He has a very large number of science papers. He's a member of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences, the National Academy of Sciences, the American Philosophical Society, has won a Humboldt Award, the Greuter Prize, Davidson Germer Prize of the American Physical Society, and the Thomas Alva Edison Patent Award in 2000. He wrote one of the great classic review papers called Optical Pumping back in 1972, still used as one of the key references in this field. In 2010, he wrote a book called Optically Pumped Atoms. So I think the thing I want to note is not only does he have a long tradition in the field of energy research, but a very distinguished pure science career as well. He's well known as a pioneer in several fields of physics, including spin exchange optical pumping, NMR, MRI with hyperpolarized noble gases, which is now widely used for imaging of lungs. He laser guide stars for adaptive optics, where he, I believe, invented the sodium guides for astronomical adaptive optics, and he's giving a seminar in the AMO seminar series tomorrow for those who'd like to go hear more about that topic. Nuclear targets for high energy physics and nuclear physics experiments. So I think with that introduction, I will turn to CO2, friend or foe. So let's thank our speakers.
I'm going to go to the next slide. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to go to the next one. I'm going to go to the next slide. Thank you. I'm going to go to the next one. Thank you. I have a I think it's fairly easy to say that some radical change in CO2 inventory total global temperature over several thousands of years would not be necessarily bad for human temperature. But very sharp ones, like
one last question.